All right, this video that I'm putting up today is a revisiting a video that I did back in 2011, actually two videos. The first one was done on May 12, 2012, and the second one of the coloring of the bronze was June 22nd of 2012. I was commissioned back then to do a bronze of a gentleman's ancestor who became famous because of a battle with the Abenaki Indians in upper state New Hampshire. He was part of a militia, he was the captain of the militia, and the modern day John Lovewell asked me to do a portrait of him, and he also asked another artist back east who's famous for doing paintings of early American subjects to do a painting of the same battle, or the just before the battle. I delivered this bronze to the client shortly after it was colored, within a week, and in Lake Tahoe, and it was so quick I had no chance to even photograph the bronze finished. But I just wanted to share this with you. Somebody asked me about it today on Facebook, and I thought it'd be a good subject for you guys to watch. Now remember, I sell my instructional DVDs on how to sculpt. It takes advantage of all the tricks of the trade that I've learned over the last 53 years, since 1965, on how to sculpt, and some of the shortcuts, some of the things you need to know, and stuff like that. Please go down to my link below, and you can see a link to the review of my instructional DVDs, and purchase one if you're interested in learning how to sculpt, or purchase all of them. But anyway, that's being said, and that's the little advertisement off the side, and let's go ahead and watch the video now. All right, I'm Dave Lemon, and this is Captain John Lovewell, who was killed by Abenaki Indians up in New Hampshire, and the pond that he was killed by, or nearby, was later named after him. And several authors, great American authors, wrote poems and a story about them. And there's a book out called The Scalp Hunters, which is a story about Captain John Lovewell. So what I'm doing right now is I've just put together a video showing the beginnings of this piece from start to finish and up to the present. And so I hope you'll enjoy this little video. I just got the box delivery from Trueform. This is the armature that's going to be used for the commission that I'm doing of Captain John Lovewell. All right, I got the armature, as you can see, from Trueform online, and they package these things up so nicely.
as you can see, the bronze is ready to be colored. And the first step is just turning it all black. And he hasn't gotten around to that yet. And here's the peace talker, which is going to be done today as well. And Lance is still working on Prayer on the Wind. And he's just cleaning that one up and getting it ready to be colored too. So we're going to be doing three bronzes today.
Yeah, I think it'll look good that way. It'll look kind of traditional, but not boring.
Like in Billings, I believe, and Helena.
Now this is the cold patina that he's putting on it now. It's all acid and chemicals. I'm not going to give you the names of them because those are well-guarded secrets.
There's no secrets on this potato. This is potash and ferric.
Yeah, potash and ferric, and that's about it. This is a potash solution he's putting on. It's sort of like when, because of the copper content in the bronze, which, by the way, I am charged extra for after it's cast. It turns potash turns that copper and the tin to a kind of a real black. Okay, what Isaac is doing now is he's rubbing back the areas of it This is Jonathan Aspenson. He's a gentleman that follows my videos and a local artist, and he just came by to watch this thing being colored today. Bigger than you thought, huh?
Oh, yeah. When you see it on monitor, that is
really something. I know you did. We're not going to hear him either.
Arrow in his leg, and they couldn't. The doctors couldn't get the traction to stop, and so they were going to have to take his leg off. He eventually died from it. Actually, he didn't die from that. He actually was stabbed about four or five times and thrown into the Tiber River.
I
got to
get going.
All right. Thanks for coming by.
Yeah, it's been fun.
Glad you got to see part of it.
Yeah. Nice to meet you, Jonathan.
Me too. I shake his hand, but it's...
It might be a little hot.
Yeah.
Pulling my imprint on. That looks really good, just the way it is right now.
Yeah. It'll look
better. Yeah, we couldn't have been faster. It's really neat when you wax it. I mean, when it's this hot and it's done, you just put wax, it melts over, it gets so... It takes a whole new level. It's really rich. And, but hey, you got things to do. It's a pretty slow process.
I gotta go to work. See you, Captain.
Adios.
Yeah.
No, it is. We can do slow. Another victim of the old bummer economy. The highlights on the edges will look good just with the light in there. Did you just sculpt the face just randomly, or did you, was there any reference as far as people describing them?
I took today's John Lovewell and photographed his face.
Today's?
Yeah, he's the direct descendant.
Oh, I got you.
And I sculpted his portrait. He's in his 50s. This guy was in his 30s.
Okay.
So I took back the age a little bit, changed some of the flavor a little bit, but it wasn't the exact portrait.
That's really cool.
And just kept his genetics, you know, like his nose and his eyes and his beard.
There's
no painting of him, and I think his face looks like somebody that looked back then.
And even if it looks nothing like he actually looked, you can say it's accurate genetics of the guy.
I'm probably dying to go up there and meet the guy and probably kick my ass and say, that doesn't look like a damn thing. And then suddenly, 3,000 years from now, they we finally discovered that. We discovered that. And it's all green.
Well, the color sure pulls the whole composition all together.
Yeah.
Just makes it seem more.
I think he's going to be real happy with it.
Well, that's the bottom line.
It's a beautiful day. It's let's see what the temperature is. No, it's 83 degrees. That's not too bad. It's just absolutely perfect day. All right, I'm coming into McAllister right now, and I just wanted to let you know that my camera died on me at the foundry. The battery just went dead, and the other battery wasn't full, you know, charged enough to even do anything. Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my Instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.